Is lack of mobility preventing you from doing the things that you love? Well, not anymore. Hi, Dr. James Vegher here. I've been a doctor of physical therapy with over 20 years of success helping people like you improve the function of their body. Today, I want to talk to you about your mobility issues. I'm also going to help you out with all of your pain problems. Stick around until the end of the video and I'll tell you how you can get access to my free pain relief quiz, which will identify your needs and give you a personalized plan to recovery. Now, when I say mobility, what I mean is simply your ability to move freely without issues or pain. Oftentimes, I have patients who have joint pain or have had surgery that has affected their ability to walk properly, get up from a chair, and perform simple tasks like picking something up from the floor. These patients can think there's no hope. The amount of recovery time from an injury or the difficulty they have in trying to get back to their previous lifestyle often surprises them. They can feel fragile and may feel fearful that they won't ever be able to engage in their life in the same way that they did before. The good news is, there is something that can be done. You can always start somewhere. You know that old phrase, if you don't use it, you lose it? Well, it's true in a lot of ways. After an injury or an episode of acute pain or surgery, for example, rest may be what is needed to help the body heal and allow the tissues time to repair. Many people are often surprised by the effect that this rest period has on their bodies. It's important to note that not only do muscles begin to atrophy in as little as 48 hours, but that atrophy has a more significant effect on the muscles that are already weakened. This can translate into a surprising amount of weakness when you start to engage in activities again. Even simple things are much more difficult than they were. Unfortunately for many, this can lead to thinking that what you need is more rest, or what is called in the medical community, fear avoidance behavior. This is when you avoid doing tasks, moving a certain way, or engaging in certain activities because of fear of pain or not being able to engage in it in the same way as you did before, or that your body is simply too fragile to perform it. This situation has many degrees of severity, but the impact on your body is the same. More muscle wasting, less movement, less enjoyment, and greater frustration that you can't do the things that you used to do. The exercise I'm going to show you is a progressive movement chain that is going to help you get your whole body moving again. It's important to understand that this is a progressive movement. Each movement is built on the previous step. If you can't do one step of the movement, don't move on to the next. That way, as long as you are moving at your own pace, you'll always be progressing. It's important to understand that, depending on the severity of your decreased mobility, re-engaging in any movement will be challenging. It will be challenging on a number of levels, but it needs to be challenging. You need to push your body to be challenged in order for it to change. Keeping your body unchallenged is what is limiting your mobility. So don't be afraid to challenge your body. That is the only way that it can change. What we want to do is retrain your muscles to move in the proper way by improving your range of motion and flexibility to get you mobile again. And again, this movement chain I'm going to show you is designed to be progressive, so don't rush your body into something it's not ready for. Increasing your mobility takes time, and I want you to know that this movement is intended for a broad audience and broad mobility issues, and you may require more specific attention. Also understand that if I was working with you one-on-one, I would be able to provide treatment and guidance on all the facets of your pain and mobility and coach you through this step by step. There is much more that goes into solving your mobility problems that encompasses your whole body, and I encourage you to check out my other videos for more comprehensive knowledge. This movement chain is called bear to squat to stand. And with this sequence of movements, we are trying to facilitate deep hip flexion and activation of your hips to support you when you're doing things like going up the stairs, going uphill, or just standing and walking. We're going to start this position on your hands and knees with your toes pulled underneath you. You're going to lift up into the bear position and then walk your hands back to a squatting position, making sure that your knees are apart and your thighs are in line or parallel to your feet. And from here, you're gonna push up to the standing position. Let's do this movement chain 7 times. I know that this is a challenging movement sequence, but listen to your body. Remember, it is supposed to challenge you, and above all, stick with it. Let me know how this went for you in the comments. Be sure you listen to your body and stop immediately if you have pain. I want you to find out the best stretch to get you out of pain. So take our free pain quiz. I put a link that you can click on to take this free pain quiz. And based on your gender, age, pain points, and a few other factors, we're going to share with you the best stretch to help you get out of pain. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you learned anything helpful, please share this video with a friend and click that thumbs up button. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button so you can get more tips and tricks for pain relief and corrective exercises. Until next time, take care of yourself.